Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach, and you're tuning in to Madden 19 on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see the Buffalo Bills and their rookie quarterback, drafted 7th overall, Josh Allen, face off with Deshaun Watson and the Houston Texans. I'll see you again with scores and updates at halftime. But for now, it's my distinct pleasure to hand things over to our broadcast team. It's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Gentlemen.
Thank you, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas, NRG Stadium in Houston. They do it big here in Houston, and a second ago it was a Texas-sized welcome for their hometown guys. They're fired up and ready to go as they get set to match up with the Buffalo Bills. Brandon Godden and Charles Davis on hand. Kickoff just moments away. Charles, quickly, keys to the game.
For me, it's coaching. Who prepared his team the best going into this one to give them the confidence to believe that they would win the game? That's who's going to come out of this one on top.
The Texans send out second-year man Kyeme Fairbairn to get us started. Two teams more than ready to get this one started. On the return, here's Marcus Murphy. So here come the Bills on offense for the first time. It's Josh Allen who will be under center, the rookie quarterback who was drafted 7th overall from Wyoming.
And for the Buffalo Bills, this is just the third time since 1983 when they drafted Jim Kelly that they've drafted a quarterback in the first round. The other two, J.P. Losman out of Tulane and E.J. Manuel out of Florida State.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10. Throwing on first down is Allen. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. He was looking for Charles Clay as tight end, and that'll bring up second down. So, Charles, let me get your thoughts on where the Bills are through 5 weeks as they come back out here on offense. A big win last week against Tennessee, Steven Hauschka, with a field goal at the end of regulation, 13-12 Bills. But, you know, after week one, I think people were saying, whoa, 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 what happened to the playoff team we saw a year ago? Now they're doing okay.
I was actually questioning it during preseason. I saw them in their third preseason game against Cincinnati, and they couldn't protect any quarterback that was on the field for them. So I just wondered how they were going to do that in the regular season. And I know preseason races are different. It was the same offensive lineman they were going to start the season with. Give them credit. When they've won their two games, they've been against significant opponents. Minnesota, preseason Super Bowl contender at Minnesota. And then how about this one against the Tennessee Titans, who got off to a 3-1 start. Looking at their schedule, they're at Houston, at Indianapolis. If they take care of business in the AFC South and clean their way through there, they've got a chance to have a much better season than we even thought. And possibly, could they contend for the second spot in the AFC East?
Here we go now. Blue Landy! Blue Landy!
Throwing is Allen on third. And that is incomplete.
Whenever I see an in route dropped, as we just saw in that play, I'm always thinking that in the back of their mind, they're worried about what's coming at them because they're going towards traffic on that route as opposed to being away from it and maybe having a little bit more space.
The Bills send the punter out. Back deep for the Texans is Tyler Ervin. Six yards on the boot. The coverage holds him to just 3 on the return. And the Texans will take over with a first and 10. So out come the Texans for their opening drive. Their franchise quarterback, the one leading him out, back to full health now for his second season out of Clemson. It's Deshaun Watson.
What a start to his NFL career as a rookie. 19 touchdown passes in just 6 starts. That was more touchdowns than Joe Flacco, Tyrod Taylor, or Marcus Mariota. And Houston went 1-8 after losing him, which lent credence to many people saying He should have been the rookie of the year based on his play and how Houston did without him.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. On the ground, this is Lamar Miller. Takes it to the 26, just a one-yard gain. And let's take a look at the Texans' offense.
Will Fuller is one of the young flyers in the NFL and gets to top speed in just a couple of steps, so everyone has to respect the deep game because he'll blow past people in a hurry. But what that does is leaves open space underneath. He can take the short pass, turn it into a bigger gain because he makes people miss. If he takes care of his hands and doesn't drop a pass or two in a game, he's going to be one of the best receivers in the league.
On second down, here's Miller. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Up to make the play defensively, Tre'Davious White.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there. Extra DB on the field for the Bills here on third down.
Yeah, maybe thinking pass. Out of the gun, Watson. Room here to run. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A first down carry now for Miller. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football getting away from one and trying to turn forward and get some yardage. I really liked what he did there.
First carry now for Tyler Ervin. 3 yards on the pickup there, and they've got it back to third and 10. Quickly now, a look at the Buffalo defense.
And Lorenzo Alexander is the ultimate chameleon in the NFL. Has reshaped his body to play different positions. Fullback, defensive tackle, defensive end, outside linebacker, special teamer. He's done it all, and now he's reaping the benefits. Fully entrenched as an outside linebacker in the NFL.
Play action for Miller. Now Watson. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Now the Bills' offense gets ready to head back onto the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10. They'll start the drive with a carry by McCoy. And he goes across midfield and down into Houston territory. Menardrick McKinney there to make the stop. And this defensive line will be looking to control the point of attack.
And that's what they've done throughout this season. This is a terrific unit. They play together very, very well, and they don't permit big plays to happen.
Throwing on second down. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to LeSean McCoy, and it's third down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass.
Let's go!
From the gun, it's Allen. And this one is incomplete.
As my dad used to tell me all the time, when you're getting ready to play a big-time game, especially when you have one going into a dome setting, better strap it up tight because that crowd can really affect things.
Especially on third downs like the one we just saw there with the incompletion. The Bills send the punter out as he'll kick it away for the second time. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. Houston's offense taking the field again, and they were one of a few teams last week that really got an important, maybe season-changing win. You know, Pittsburgh had one, the Vikings had one, but the Houston Texans, a team that could have dropped to 1-4, but they won in OT against Dallas.
And you remember in preseason, I thought Atlanta would go to the Super Bowl. They're at 1-4, and they're really struggling because of injuries as well. Houston was another team that I said would be greatly improved and could be a surprise team, and they are starting to hit their stride in the AFC South. Got to overtime with Dallas, backed up on their own 10-yard line, and Deshaun Watson leads the drive for the game-winning field goal. How about the throw he made to DeAndre Hopkins, and how about the run after catch, where Hopkins became a whirling dervish twice to pick up big yardage and set up Fairbairn for the game-winning field goal? Look out now. They can get to 500 next week at home against Buffalo. And before what could be a huge game at Jacksonville in week 7.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He lost two there, and it's third down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, third and long. Third and long, it's Watson. And that's caught by Smith. He's at the 40, the 20, 10, touchdown, Houston. A big play there, 83 yards. And the Texans have taken the early lead.
Pardon me, you know the real key is to stopping a good passing attack?
You tell me.
Being able to tackle as soon as a guy catches a football.
Didn't work out there.
No, because when you give up the big run after catch, the rack yardage, that puts your defense in a big-time stressful position.
A lot of rack yardage and a touchdown there on the big play. Kaimi Fairbairn on for the extra point. And oh, it's blocked. So the drive there, they went 80 yards in three plays. And the result, a Houston touchdown. Fairbairn now to kick this one away. Now it's Murphy. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10.
Set! Green 39! Green 39!
Allen now on first down. And his throw is incomplete. Charles Clay has tied in the intended target, and now it's second down.
All right, that one fell incomplete there, but the best quarterbacks, they'll miss on 40% of their throws somewhere in that neighborhood, similar to a great hitter in baseball who's going to fail 7 out of 10 times and still have a great year. In this case, you want perfection, but way better that it hits the ground instead of going to an opposite color jersey.
Allen again here on second and 10. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. The linebacker, Zach Cunningham, there defensively to make that play.
Well, it certainly appears that they're going to try and keep getting him the football. It's the third time they've looked in his direction. Unfortunately, haven't completed one yet, but I'm not sure they're going to shy away from it. They feel like they've got something there, and they want to capitalize on it.
I think you're right. We're only in the first quarter, so a lot of opportunities ahead. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions.
Set! Blue landed! Blue landed!
So the shotgun snap to Allen. And he'll jack this one down to McCoy. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards and a Buffalo first down. So finally completes his first pass. Credit the defense, though. They've been showing him some different looks, keeping him off balance.
Yeah, I like the observation that you had there, because when you give him different looks and give any quarterback different looks, it takes just a little bit longer to process sometimes, and you don't throw the ball with the same confidence. You're not sure that that's where you should go with the football, and that's worked for the defense early in this game, and now he's got his first completion. Let's see if his confidence comes back, and he starts to get into a nice little groove.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Set! 319! 319!
On first down, Allen. And he is going to go down. They sack him on the final play of the first quarter. A look up to the scoreboard as time has run out. On this first quarter, 6-0 is our score. We're back to Houston in just a moment.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter about to get underway with the Bills in possession. But they face a second and long to start things out.
Let's go! Green!
On the counter, here's McCoy. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It's a loss of two, now third down. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division, every year, is trying to make sure they draft people charged with trying to block J.J. Watt. So far, hasn't been too successful.
First and second down were a disaster. Both went backwards. Now it's third and 18. They need something big. Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. And this is going to be incomplete.
And based on my math, they've only converted one time thus far in this game. So you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. Third downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
The Bills send the punter out as he'll come on to kick this one away. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. Shifts by him. Oh, and now he bowls him over. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And here comes the Texans now. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now a play fake here on first down. Under a heavy rush and down he goes. Jerry Hughes in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about eight. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run-stuffing variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down and make it simple. The guy who's the right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback. He's going to put him on the ground.
To throw on second is Watson. Forced out to his left. They give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain.
Partner was a definite passing down, but he was able to leak out and pick up some good yardage, even though the coverage was excellent. Maybe it's not exactly how they drew it up, but he still got a big chunk of yardage on second down.
The Texans on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 8.
Down! Who waiting?
A shotgun snap for Watson. And that is incomplete. Tre'Davious White, a member of the all-rookie team a year ago, there to knock it away.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
The Texans send the punter out as he's on to kick it away. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. And the Bills getting set to go. The results for them so far, not that great. Well, not good at all. 3 drives, 3 punts.
Yeah, and now what you're doing is you're looking at your play sheet, trying to figure out what you're going against defensively. I wonder, are they showing them something they haven't seen or anticipated in practice, and maybe that's throwing them off? Or do they just have to go to a different play calling section and try and run some offense that way?
Allen and the Bills now with a 1st and 10.
Let's go! Green 39! Green 39!
They go play action here on first down. And he can't quite bring it in. Might have heard footsteps there across the middle. Second down.
While we have a second on that incompletion, we got to talk about Linval Joseph.
Yes,
64-yard interception return for a touchdown, and then you saw him on the sideline with the glasses and the oxygen mask after.
Yeah, when you're talking about lugging not just a football, but probably about 350 pounds
yeah.
down the sideline and scoring. But how about the contrast? Marcus May, the defensive back for the New York Jets, he gets a pick in the end zone. Brings it all the way back. I believe it's the last play of the game. And Cortland Sutton, the rookie out of SMU for Denver, knocks him out of bounds before he can score. 104 yards and no touchdown. Linval Joseph at least got the touchdown to earn the oxygen and the shade.
Well, when he was going down the field, he was in Philly. I was in Atlanta. My couch was shaking. No question. Charles, I think sometimes maybe we take LeSean McCoy for granted. Been in the league since 2009. He's played 12 or more games every season as a running back. 30 years old this year. What do you see for his future?
I still see a very bright future for him, and you're exactly right. We do kind of take him for granted. Remember, he was with Philly.
And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42.
How about that? Well, the so-called little guys putting the pressure on. That was a strong safety. When I was in college, we often called that a lightning blitz.
The Bills send the punter out. He's been terrific so far. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback.
Getting set to go again, DeAndre Hopkins marches back onto the field. Not only does he not have a catch, I don't think he's been targeted in this game, but they're winning.
And if you ask a receiver of his magnitude, he'll tell you that it's because everyone is focused on him anyway. Okay, you've taken it away. No catches, no targets, but we're still winning. I've opened things up for the rest of my team. I know how receivers think.
They've been using him as a decoy, and effectively so. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at the 20.
Here's Watson. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Watson hands to Miller on the draw. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Green, they're down. Green, they're down.
Throwing on third down, Watson. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. His first catch, good for 9 and a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
So first and 10 now from the 30. First and 10, Watson. And this one complete to Will Fuller. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Down,
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Houston after this timeout. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Down, it's Watson. Wide open receiver complete. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
The Texans with the first opportunity now from the red zone. They've got a first and 10 at the 15.
Red, green, they're down. Green, they're down.
From the red zone now, Watson. That is caught. Hopkins for the Texans touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Texans will add on to their lead. And in the red zone, I guess this is why you have a guy like that on your roster.
Without a doubt, and if you have him, you use him, because he's a guy who's going to win just about every time. I don't care what the coverage is.
Fairbairn now to add the extra point. This time, the extra point up and good. And the lead now stands at 13. So the drive there took 6 plays, and it results in the Texans finding the end zone. Fairbairn now to kick this one away. Now it's Murphy. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Bills offense coming out, ready to take over. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because 3 straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. His throw incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zay Jones that time, and that'll bring up second down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things.
All right, here we go. Green 39! Green 39!
Back to the air on second down. It's Allen. Caught on the left side by Benjamin. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Here's Allen on first and 10. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. On first and 10, Allen will set up the screen to McCoy. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So the offensive unit called the TO. And now we are ready to resume play. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7.
Let's go! 319! 319!
Again, they'll throw with Allen. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
The Bills on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 7.
Set! Blue 90! Blue 90!
Allen to throw once more. Airing one out deep for Holmes here. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined, but sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And they will indeed get on the board here, but still trailing. It's now 13-3. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted, but I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
Well, and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out of the field to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll get this just up past the 20, but a marker is down. Let's get the call.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
They were trying to create some space to run. They created the penalty.
And you work on it so much. You work on it so hard. but it's tough to simulate game speed in practice. That often runs you into a penalty.
So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Watson hands this to Foreman. And a very short pickup there across the 15 to the 16. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
So we've come upon halftime here in Houston, and it's the home team, the Texans, leading this one. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one has been a hard-hitting affair to this point, and you gotta expect we'll see more of the same in the second half. And to bring the action your way, let's get it right back out to Brandon Godd.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. It's the Texans in front, and they're going to get the football first as we are back underway in the third quarter. This is taken at his 4. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spend the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10, just shy of the 30.
Hey, Red, who ready?
Watson. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. The counter, it's Miller, and an alley to run, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. They get 14 on that one, good for a Houston first down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now a first down throw, Watson. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. Star Latulele with a great push up front. He picks up the sack and a loss of 8.
They need to stop to get back into this game, and here's one right to start the third quarter.
Yeah, anytime you go into the lockers with that 2-3-score deficit, you're right. You need that stop, get the football back, and they've done just that.
Series to series, play to play.
Imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18.
10, flat 22.
from the gun. Here's Watson.
He's got Fuller.
And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And, boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
The Texans on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Out of the gun, Watson. And an alley to run. And avoids the contact by sliding. Call it a pickup of 7, and that's going to make it 4th down. The Texans send the punter out as he's on here to punt it away. So here's the Bills offense. Now they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter 3.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. Throwing on first down is Allen, and nearly picked off there, and it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's 2nd down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game.
Here we go now. Green.
Allen will try again on 2nd down. And he comes back with 1 complete. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 12 yards that time, and a Bills 1st down. This quarterback now a woeful 5 of 17 thus far, but he's got a 1st and 10 here.
Here we go now. 3-19.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Again, it's McCoy. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down.
Now let's go. Blue 90.
They'll try and run for it with McCoy. And he's got the 1st down as he's up to the 45-yard line. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. Now on first down, going to drop this off to McCoy, complete. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. A gain of four on the play, and it's a second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
All right, here we go.
On second down, here's Allen. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
All right, here we go.
Throwing is Allen on third. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
The Bills send the punter out. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at the 40.
Down, back 22.
To throw is Watson, operating from the gun. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Watson going to give this one to Miller. Oh, he's got a little daylight. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Texans in control of the football and leading this game as well as we start the fourth. The Texans on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 4.
Down! Black 22! Black 22!
Operating from the gun, Watson. Bind, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Jerry Hughes in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Ooh. The Texans send the punter out as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And here come the Bills. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10.
Here we go. Green 39.
On first down, Allen. And his throw here is incomplete.
But plain and simple, that's the second time today that he's dropped a pass.
And that one, I think, maybe even a little easier than the earlier one that he dropped. Surprising.
Was this game announced as a night game prior to it? Maybe his rhythm is just off.
He's
got thrown off. He's going to have to wake up, enjoy the sunshine, and go play.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Let's go. Green, 39. Green.
Allen throwing again. And his throw is incomplete. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there. And now it's third down.
This has been a really nice day for the defense. They've made it so difficult to find open receivers because they're able to squeeze the passing lanes down. A lot of what they're doing is communicating. Receivers in one area, receivers in another area. They're almost what they call passing them off from one defender to the next, even in zone defenses, and making it very hard to find an open spot for the quarterback to deliver the ball.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. From the gun, it's Allen. And that will be incomplete as well.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
One final try here for Allen. And that is incomplete. The Bills' drive stalls out on fourth down. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now, really hoping for a turnover. Tenth carry now for Lamar Miller. And he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15. You can really tell right now both sides have amped up the aggressiveness. That time the offense winning the aggression battle.
And the defense was obviously aiming for the football, maybe a little bit more so than the runner himself. And that's why he was able to break through and get the gain that he did.
Here's Watson now on second down. And his throw is going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. And it'll bring up third down. First quarter, Charles, you really emphasized the importance of winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. They haven't forced a single turnover in this game.
And right now they're losing, so no turnovers might lead to no victory.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and 6. Now it's Watson, and this is going to be incomplete. Well, not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. The kick by Fairbairn is good. And the lead stretches, 16-3 now. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
Fairbairn now following the made field goal. He'll send this one away. Now it's Murphy. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
And that is incomplete. It's dropped by his tight end, Charles Clay. That'll bring up second down.
Trying to get that one to his tight end, and they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet, unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Allen again here on second and 10. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. So the shotgun snap to Allen. And that's incomplete.
Well, struggles continue. Open targets, and he keeps missing them. Pressing way too much. He may have a big arm, but until he learns how to harness it and have some touch, he's going to continue to struggle.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
Here we go.
Now Allen, gotta have this one. Looking for Benjamin, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Kayvon Webster. And his guys are gonna take over at their own 48-yard line.
Well, you're trailing, it's the fourth quarter, and you've gotta throw the football. But the defense knows this too. So they're just gonna sit back, bring in an extra defensive back or two, the old nickel or dime strategy, Brandon, and wait for you to put that bad boy up for grabs. And this one winds up being intercepted.
And now out comes Houston. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best.
Put your foot on the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. After the interception, here's Watson. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Play action from Miller. Now Watson. He's going to go for a big play down. This is caught at the 20. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Fights loose. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
Delay of game, offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards.
Still second down.
So the delay of game penalty moves it back 5. That makes it 2nd and 10. After the penalty, it's Miller. They'll get to him just inside the 15-yard line. And even after that fancy footwork we saw, a good job defensively to recover. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take. It's a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's a 5-yard pickup, but spotted a few chain links short of the first, so a little bit of decision time here coming up on fourth down. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They've got a fourth down here in a game that looks to have been decided already. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This is a 26-yard attempt. Fairbairn able to put this one through. And that will swell the lead to 16. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Fairbairn now following the made field goal. He'll send this one away. Now it's Murphy. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Back onto the field now comes the Bills offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10.
Set! Green, 39!
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. This complete to the tight end, Clay. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. Able to get away. It's complete right side to Benjamin. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. He got 29 yards that time. First down now, but that clock rolling. On first down, Allen. And this is caught at the 8. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. And again, it's Allen. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Well, they knew a lot of steps had to happen here. They got step one, the touchdown. You need a two-point conversion here, don't you?
You do, and as you continue to look ahead, if they're able to get that, somehow get the ball back and get another score, they have to go for two again. That's why teams are practicing multiple two-point plays.
We saw that Super Bowl 51 with the Patriots getting a pair of big two-point conversions. So now an important conversion attempt here as the Bills line up to go for two.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
They'll try and run it with McCoy. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. A very pivotal two-point try that does not go their way. Now it's a big uphill battle for the rest of the fourth quarter.
The attempt was to try and make it a one-score game, right? Touchdown, get two, now you've tied it up. Instead, they don't get it, still down 10.
So two scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hand seam. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Deshaun Watson and the Texans offense trot back out there. So, Charles, there are the numbers. What's happened here? Defensive adjustments that's caused him to sort of fall off a bit?
I think so. That has to happen. You've got to make some changes because in the first half, they were pretty effective. But the second part is sometimes when you're doing really well, you get off your game a little bit. You get off the gas a little. You're like, okay, we've got this thing. And that's not necessarily the case. Maybe right now, someone just needs to tell a joke in the huddle, loosen things up, and get their big guy going again.
Now Foreman. Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in quarter number four. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. They keep it on the ground. This time, it's Miller. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Now the Bills will take another timeout as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense, as the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. Down to a knee here as the Texans look to let the clock roll.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.